Hello student, class 10 student, welcome you all in today's English grammar session. And in this session I will teach you English tenses. So today we are talking or we learn English tenses, the rules, the sentence formation, the use of all tenses with the certain example and with such a three or four exercises too. So student will learn today all 12 tenses in detail. So let's learn. So in this session I will teach you most probably present continuous, present simple and present perfect continuous, progressive, like this kind of tenses. And the rest tenses in next session I will teach you. Okay, so let's begin. The different structure: simple, continuous and perfect. As we know that there are three kind of tenses, mean the structure of the tenses are three kind. Simple, continuous means progressive. See, we can say progressive for continue, we can use, okay. Progressive and continuous both are same. And perfect, in simple we have infinitive, like 2 plus verb 1. So in simple tense generally we have infinitives, okay. In continuous, as you know, to be verb plus ing. To be verb means am, is, are, was, where, have, has, okay, like that. To be verb plus ing form of the verb, like play ka play, you understand. And in perfect form we have, has plus past participle. As you can see here, past participle, okay. So different structures we have for particular all three tenses: present, past and future. We have simple, continuous means progressive, and perfect, okay. So let's see the tenses: present tense, past tense and future tense. So in this lesson I will teach you this present, past and future. Present tense have another four sub-tenses, like present simple, present progressive means present continuous, present perfect continuous, okay. And in past, same as present tense: past simple, past progressive, past perfect and past perfect continuous or past perfect progressive. In future tense, as we know, same like above, future simple, future continuous. But in future tense we don't have future perfect or future perfect continuous, because future going to is there, that's why. Okay student, so these are the tenses which we gonna learn today. Okay, first let's start with the present simple. The present tense have the four sub-tense, like present simple, present progressive, present perfect and present perfect progressive. And this, let's learn the first, the present simple tense. How to write whenever you want to write present simple, then how to write it? So first you must know that, you know that infinitive is always there, means verb is always there. There is no to be verb, no ed, no ing, but verb is there. So infinitive is there. I play, I come, very simple. With the subject you can use verb 1. Verb 1, you know na, v1, v2, v3 is there, like play, played, played, go, gone, went, come, came, like that. So v1 you can use. He, she, it, any pronoun or noun plus infinitive plus s. Why s is there? Because whenever you will have the subject with he, she or it, then you can add s or es at last, means to the verb. As I told you that in present simple what happened, subject plus verb banata hai. But if subject is he, she, it and any person singular name like Raju, like Reena, then Reena play not, but Reena plays, प्ले बिकम प्लेज वेन एवर यू विल हैव ही शी इट एज अ सब्जेक्ट. ओके लाइक ही प्लेज ही कम्स बट आई प्ले आई कम. सो आई वी यू दे के साथ वी वन एंड ही शी इट के साथ ई एस एंड एस. ओके नाउ इन क्वेश्चन डू एंड डज इज देयर प्लस वर्ब वन लाइक डू यू प्ले डज ही प्ले. वी कैन यूज डू विद I, we, you, they, and we can use does with he, she, it. In negative, we can write do not and does not. Yeah, don't and doesn't. Same. I, we, you, they. If you have as a subject, then do not. And if you have he, she, it, then does not. Okay? So, doesn't come or don't play like that. How to make he, she, it? Forms. How you can understand that where you can use s or es? Then here we have some rules, student. Most verb, if you want to change into simple present tense, what you need to do is only put s. Okay, like come, comes. But when you have to put s or es, whenever the subject is singular and as a pronoun he, she, it. Okay, and if the verb ends with s, sh, ch, x, o, then you can add es. You can see here the red highlighted word es is there. Whenever you will have the last word s, sh, ch, x and o in the verb spelling, then you can use es. Okay, like pass, then passes, wash, then washes. Okay, and if y is there, then y become I, and then e, you put es, as you know. Okay, that if y is there and before y is the consonant word is there, the consonant not the vowel, then y become I. You can see here in the fly, f l y, before y we have l, and L is the consonant, it is not the vowel. If A, E, I, O, U, any five vowels, any one vowel is there out of this five, then you no need to use I, E, S, only E, S, okay? But we have before Y consonant, so put I, E, S, Y become I. So these are the rule that we can use E, S or S whenever we have the verb and with this, and whenever we have singular as a subject means he, she, it or any one name like Neha, like Raju, like Reena, like Shyam, okay, that time we can use es or s for verb. But I, we, you, they, if there as a subject or plural is there, like Raju and Reema play cricket, but if Reema is there, then Reema plays cricket, like that. Okay, and do does we can use for question, and do not and does not as a negative. How to use this present simple? As we know all the rules, right, but where I should use in daily life? So we have here use of simple present. The simple present is used to talk about things that are always true. Where we can use the simple present is, student, whenever we are talking about the things which are always true, there is no chance to become these things lie in future, because this remains same for the thousand and thousand years. So whenever you are telling something true, that time you can use present simple. For example, sun rises in the east. Now you know sun always rises in the east. Have you ever seen that today sun rises from the south and north? No. So this is the universal truth. Okay, student. So whenever you have universal truth, that time you can use simple present. Subject plus verb one plus object. Or subject singular hai, to subject plus verb plus es or s at last of the verb, and then object, as we have put es to the rises, because rise word and with s, so that's why. Okay, so the sun, and the sun is singular word, so that sun rises in the east. habits, when we are talking about habits and the routine and things that happen repeatedly daily, that time we can use present tense. For example, Joe plays golf on Sundays. Whenever the Sunday comes, Joe generally plays golf. So each and every Sunday of the month and his life, every Sunday he plays golf. So this is the routine. Of course, this is not the daily routine of Joe, but actually this is the routine or the habit of Joe, the Sunday habit. As you can say, like, I wake up daily in the morning, in the early morning. So this is your daily routine. But I ke saath, I use verb one as I wake up. Why use wake? Because the subject is I is there. But if you are talking about she or he, then she wakes up daily early in the morning. Okay, so she ke saath as es wakes aa jata hai, then I ke saath wake, like Joe ke saath as laga place, because Joe is the singular name. Okay, only one name is there, that's my student. So here that where we can use simple present for daily routine or for daily activities, for routine activities, whatever, if it is in month or twice in a month, once in a month, but it is daily, it is routine. If it is once in a year, but each and every year Diwali comes. Why we say each and every year Diwali comes? Because Diwali plus we one plus es lagaya as a simple present, because this is the routine. As we know, from the 1000 years Diwali comes, that's why. So whenever you're talking about habits and routine, you can use this simple present tense. Whenever you're talking about the universal truth, the true fact, that time you can use simple present tense. And what is the simple present tense structure, student? Yes, subject plus verb plus verb SES plus object. Okay, here we have see examples. What kind of a disguise is this? Little Red Hood. This is this dialogue from this tall girl, and now this small girl say something. I have got a routine. When I go out, I wear sunglasses and a red hoodie, because I want to be incognito. Now see, this red t-shirt girl said to the black t-shirt girl that what is the routine of this girl. When you can see one thing in the dialogue, that she's talking about routine. So she use I go out, she use I ke saath go verb one, and I wear. So I wear, where is the V1. So here she use present simple, because she is talking about the routine, that whenever she go out, she used to wear sunglasses and red hoodie. That's why. The present continuous. Let's understand the present progressive or present continuous, we can say. Okay. First, we must know the subject sentence pattern of this, that what is the sentence pattern, then subject plus MER plus ing plus object is the pattern. You can see in the, on the screen, MER plus ing is the subject form, sentence formation, sorry, of this tense. Now you have to do one thing is, whenever you have I, then you can use am. Whenever you have he, she, it, then is. And whenever you have you, we, are, so these are the plural or the pronoun like this, you, we, are, our. So this time you can use are over there, or if you will have plural as a subject, that kind time also you can use are. For example, we are, you are, okay, then Raju and Ramu are best friend. यू यूज आर विद प्लूरल एंड यू एंड वी के साथ, बट आई के साथ एम आता है एंड इज कम्स विद दी ही शी इट और सिंगुलर लाइक रीमा इज डांसिंग शी इज डांसिंग लाइक दैट. ओके बट वॉट इज द सेंटेंस फॉर्मेशन इज सब्जेक्ट प्लस एम इज आर प्लस आई एन जी ऑफ वर्ब. ओके लाइक आई एम प्लेइंग आई एम कमिंग एंड इन क्वेश्चन यू कैन यूज टू बी वर्ब्स इन द एट द स्टार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस यू कैन यूज एट द वेरी फर्स्ट दिस टू बी वर्ब्स यू नो ना टू बी वर्ब्स एम इज आर आर दी सपोर्टिंग और टू बी वर्ब्स. ओके सो एम इज आर यू कैन पुट एट द फर्स्ट वेन एवर यू वॉन्ट टू फ्रेम द क्वेश्चन लाइक आर यू प्लेइंग इज शी प्लेइंग या इज शी कमिंग. ओके एंड नेगेटिव यू जस्ट पुट नॉट ओनली. ओके लाइक आई एम नॉट प्लेइंग ही इज नॉट प्लेइंग या ही इजंट प्लेइंग. सो यू कैन यूज द शॉर्ट फॉर्म ऑफ इज नॉट इजंट. हाउ टू मेक आई एन जी फॉर्म्स if you want to make ing form then most of the verbs you just do I put ing and no need to do any change but there is some certain changes over there let's see how kind of they are. Most verbs only put ing like open become opening verb ending in e whenever the verb ends with e then do one thing remove e and put ing like drive dr I V E is there but when you put ing V you need to remove the vowel V so it becomes D R I V I N G driving that is changed to Y I E sorry I E changed to Y if the verb end with I E the last two verb of the any verb is I E then I become Y and ing so I become Y like L I E lie hai to L Y I N G lying ho jayega. Understand one vowel plus one consonant is there the double consonant is there like stop then stopping ho jayega if there is one vowel and one consonant then see P is the last word consonant and before P what is there O is there so one vowel and one consonant is there at the last then you can write the double consonant okay so double p ho jayega to stopping like that where we can use this how to use this present continuous we have discussed and we you learned most probably that what is the sentence formation what are the rule of present continuous but where you can use as you know that simple present tense use for the daily routine life and universal truth so where we use present continuous let's see simple present is used for daily but here present continuous used to talk about the things that are happening now or around now whenever you want to talk something about which thing or the action is actually right now in front of you going on for example if you are sitting in the room now and watching my videos so you right now student what you are doing you are watching so why I use ing m is r plus ing because the thing is going on now it is happening now or I think around now only so I can use that student are watching my videos why because now they are doing this so whenever you want to talk about the happening things which is happening right now and around right now that time you can use present continuous and what is the sentence pattern of course subject plus I m is r plus ing plus verb okay like I am working just now I am reading an interesting book so it doesn't mean that I am reading it right now but that the reading of the book is in progress these days in the second sentence you see I am reading an interesting book it doesn't mean that now the person is reading actually of course you can use as a progressive continuous for the things which is going on daily going on means the book is progresses these days, that he is completing this book to read, okay, like that. Verbs normally not used in the present continuous. Hate, know, like, love, mean, need. These are the verbs which we most probably we do not use in present continuous. Have you ever heard that I am loving you? No. Because have you ever heard that I am liking you? I am knowing this? No. I am hating you? No. We never use ing with such a verb like hate, know, like, love, mean, need, perfect, seem, understand, okay, want. So you do not use ing of this verb, okay. You can use wanted, hated, hated, okay, no, new, like, liked, loved, meant, needed, preferred, seemed. You can use in past, but you can't use these verbs normally for the present continuous, okay. So these verb are not action verb, that's why whenever you using action verb, that's related to continuous. And if you want to talk about such a things which is happening now, or it may be happening around now, then you can use present continuous. A continuous tense is only used with action verbs, as this is the general knowledge, okay. It's used with action word only. What are you doing? We can frame a question with what, okay, and then to be verb. I am cycling and trying to catch a ball. You can see this girl, she is trying to catch the ball at this time, and she is, I think, cycling, okay. We can see in front of our eyes that this is the action which is going on. And what are you doing? Now she asked to this man, then he say, I am running, but I don't like this. And this man, I think we can see that he is maybe running, but he don't like this. So that he say, I don't like this. So whenever you want to say something about the thing which is happening in front of your eyes, you can use subject plus am is I plus object. Let's see the exercise of present simple and present continuous, okay. Put the verb listen and look into the correct tenses in this sentence. Amy usually listen to the news on the radio in the morning. Same is listening to a concert of the radio at the moment. My sister always looks for unusual things to bring back when she goes on holiday. We are looking for Allison's purse. She can't find it anywhere. So here we have used simple present tense and continuous tense. Okay. Let's understand the next. Make the question of, okay, using the prompts like foreign, food, and like. We have to work, but with do, does, or am, is, are, or what, which, where, wh words, we can use this and can frame a question. Okay, foreign, food, and like hai. So we can use like, do you like foreign food, do you want foreign food, like that. Okay. Need talk go camping. So what do you need to take when you go camping? What one do after the lesson? What do you want to do after the lesson? Season prefer. Which season do you prefer? There anything really hate do? Is there anything you really hate doing? Like that you can frame a sentence. This exercise seem difficult. So does this exercise seem difficult? You can use does here, okay, for making question. So here we have this kind of exercise which I can ask you in examination too, like this kind of fill in the blanks or this kind of too. Okay, as understand the third, the present perfect, as we have understand present simple and present progressive. Let's understand the third one is the present perfect. So what is the sentence pattern? Let's understand that first. Whenever you want to write present perfect, then you have to keep one thing, that there is subject. As we know, each and every sentence have subject. Subject are noun and pronoun. Okay, subject mein koi bhi name ya pronoun ho sakte hai, like Reema ho sakta hai, otherwise instead of Reema she bhi ho sakta hai, then after verb and then after object, we know, right? So here you have to write first subject, then after have, has. According to subject you can use have, has. Have comes with the plural and I, we, you, they, and has come with the singular subject, and he, she, it ke saath has aata hai, like she has, he has, it has, Reena has, Ram has. But when you are talking about I, then I have, you have, we have, Ram and Shyam have. When you have plural subject, then you can use have. Okay, so have, has we can use with singular plural subject. Then verb, of course have, has ke saath aayega verb 3, past participle of verb. As I told you, there is form of verbs, verb 1, verb 2, verb 3, verb 4. So in verb 3 comes to this present perfect. As verb 1 is same, it is same as it root verb, like play, played, played, come, can, come. Go, go is verb 1, went is verb 2, then gone is verb 3. So verb 3 here comes, have, has plus V3, your past participle. If you don't want to use past participle, you can use V3. Okay student, so I have played, I have come, like that. If you want to make question, then do not need to do anything, just have, has come to the first and then subject and then last word. So have you played, has he come, like that. Okay, in negative use not only, for short form you can use haven't, hasn't, like I haven't played, I haven't come. How to make past participle? See, regular past participle end in ed, but irregular past participle, see the list third column, right? As I told you, go, went, gone. Okay, these are the irregular. But play, played, played, so most of the V3 are end with ed. But some of the irregular, there we no need to use ed over there, because it changes itself, like drunk, drink, drank, drunk. So drunk is the totally different from the drink. There is no need to use ed, drunk nahi bolte hai, so that the irregular past participle are there. How to use, where we need to use this? If you are using this, if you want to, you know already the sentence formation, but you don't know what is the use, where I could use this, then it is well. So we must know the use, right? So we use this, the present perfect, used to talk about the past and the present. Yes, the present perfect is the sentence which used for the past and for the present moment. Yeah, like I have made a cake, would you like some? I have made a cake. See here, I means the subject, have plus V3, made is the have plus V3 past perfect, and a cake is the object. I means, for example, your mother. For example, your mother have made a cake in the morning, and now this is evening time. But your mother is actually talking about cake right now, which he has made by her in the morning. Whatever she is talking about past in the present, that's why she use perfect present. Understand? So perfect present used for past and present both. So here you can see, I have made a cake. Would you like some? Like that. Give news. When you want to give news, you can use present perfect. Like the Prime Minister has arrived in Washington. And see how long something has continued up to now. If you want to say something which has started in the past, for 5 days ago, but still it is running on, then you can use present perfect. Like, I have lived here for 2 years. Okay, actually you come to the Surat or to the Bombay before 2 years, but even though still you are living now, then you can use I have lived here for 2 years. If you want to talk about past situation in the present, you can use present perfect. For example, have you ever skied? Oh yes, we have even skied in summer. Look how tall I am. I have grown. Like this way, we can use this kind of sentence with present perfect. Let's see the fourth one, the last one of present perfect tense is present perfect continuous tense. Here you can see the combination of continuous and perfect tense. Okay, what is the sentence formation? Have has plus been plus ing. Okay, subject plus have has been plus ing. Like, if, as I told you, I, we, you, they, if there as a subject or plural is there, then have. And if he, she, it and singular subject is there, then has you can use. Plus been plus ing. Okay, like I have been playing, I have been learning. For the question, you can use have first, then subject, then been, and then ing form. Like, have you been playing? Has he been playing? Like that. Has he been learning? Like that. In negative, you can use not only, that I have not been playing, I have not been learning, like that. Okay, so where we need to use this, where we should use, so how to use it, we must know. So the perfect present, present perfect continuous use for the unfinished action continuing up to now. Unfinished action means student, imagine that now you are in the Surat, right? And now you are watching this video since 2 days, I think. For example, this is the third day you are watching, because you are watching 5 or 10 minutes, because at 30 minute thoroughly you don't want to watch. So you have started this video to watch 3 days ago, and still you are watching since 3 days, then it says something like unfinished action is running on till today. You, for example, 3 days ago means Saturday you, or Friday you try to watch, and Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and today Tuesday comes. But even though you are watching, so that is unfinished action which you are continuing. Okay, which unfinished action is the watching videos, and now you are still watching. So that is perfect continuous, that you have started in the past, but still it is running on, it is not stopped here, it is still running on. That is perfect continuous. Like, have you been waiting long? Like that. And another use of this is to see how we have been filling our time up to now. Like, sorry, I haven't written, I have been traveling. Like that. Okay, here we have some of the sentence. We have been cycling, and like, you look tired, what you have been doing? Then she said, we have been cycling and pushing our heavy bikes and walking all days. We have been cycling means, I think, whole day, from morning to the noon. Continuously 5 hours they have been cycling. That's why they use subject plus have has been plus ing. Okay. Let's see the exercise of present perfect and present perfect continuous. Complete the conversation with the present perfect and present perfect continuous. I have written already the question's answer. Laura and Trevor, these are the two friends, I think, and they have some conversation with each other in dialogue. Let's see. Laura says, "What are you doing, Trevor? You have been, you plus me means you and to be verb. You have been in here for ages. You are making an awful mess, Trevor. I have been cleaning out this cupboard most of the afternoon. There's a lot of old stuff in here. I have found this book. Look, Laura, you have been sitting there staring at those old books for the last 5 minutes. I have been watching you, Trevor. They are my football boots. I have had them since I was about 16. They have been in the here for years," Laura says. "Well, throw them away. And what about that tennis racket? Is that yours, Trevor?" "No, it must be yours. I have never had a tennis racket." So here you can see how present perfect and present continuous used, that these both characters are talking about the things which they have since many years, but still they have. That's why that the past and the present combine together. If the things you have since 10 years or 20 years, but still you are you are watching it, you have it, then it's called present perfect continuous. Okay, so for today, children, this much only. I have explained you all the four types and all the sub tenses of present, okay, tense. In next session we'll teach you past tense and future tense, okay, and we'll give you homework. If you could not find the answer, we'll give you answer key also, don't worry. And please, for having the great knowledge of regarding all these present tense parts, then you have to do practice at home of this. If you want this in the PDF file, we'll send you in study material too, don't worry. So I hope you understand all about present tense, that today I have explained you the present simple. We have seen that present simple is used for daily routine or the universal truth. Subject plus V1 plus object, yeah, subject plus V1 ESS object, okay. And then we understand present continuous, that the sentence formation is subject plus MSR plus ING plus object, right. And it is used for the things which is right now running on in front of your eyes and is around running. And then we have understand the present perfect, the formation of this is subject plus have has plus V3 and plus object. And where we can use this, as we have used this, or we can use in past and present. And if we want to give news then, and if we say something that how long something has continued up to now, still now, which has started in the past, for that you can also use present perfect. Then I explained you the present perfect continuous, combination of perfect and continuous tense. In this, that sentence pattern is subject plus have has been plus ing, okay. And you can use this for action continue up to now, which is unfinished in the past, but still it is continuous. And if you want to say how we have been feeling our time up to now, you can talk about that too with the help of present perfect continuous. And we have also solved this 2 and 2 is equal to 4 exercise of this present tense. So I hope you understand the present tense totally, and I can understand you know better once you do practice on this. Okay, we'll ask you question related to present continuous and present perfect and simple and perfect and all in the form of filling the blanks and like change into negatives and all. So do practice at home, student, for this. Okay, and for today this much only. We'll meet in the next session. Till then, students, stay home, stay safe, learn well. Thank you, student.